Today I'm going to show you how to make an octagon placemat using fat quarters and scraps, or just scraps alone. These wonderful little placemats go together very quickly. This has started out as a fat quarter, so it is 17 inches across, a generous size. It can also be used as a table topper. This one has a wine theme to it. You can make them for all the holidays. Here's a Christmas one. How about for your coffee group? Here's one with a fun tropical theme. For the chef in your life. And an autumn one. The key is to start out with a square of fabric. The size of square you start out with will determine the size of your finished placemat. Smaller squares make smaller octagons. Here'd make a great trivet. How about a mug rug? A larger square, of course, you would get a much larger octagon. Table toppers. Today we're going to make an octagon placemat beginning with a fat quarter. I have taken my fat quarter and cut it down to 12 inches square, a perfect square. I'm going to flip it over so that the right side is on the table. I'm going to fold it in half lengthwise, and then I will lightly press that crease there, open it up, fold it on the diagonal, lightly press that crease as well. Now I'm ready to form my octagon. What I want to do where the diagonal line and the vertical line intersected, I want to take a pen and put a little dot in there on the wrong side of the fabric. And then I will put a pin on the right side of the fabric through that dot. Taking the bottom left-hand corner, I'm going to fold the square up to the dot where the pin is, and I'm going to take the vertical line and match it up with the diagonal line right there, and you'll notice also that this line is perpendicular to the square. When I've done that, when I've completed that, I'm going to take my rotary cutter and I'm going to cut this triangle off. I'm going to cut this triangle off. I'm going to flip my work over, and now I'll cut this triangle off and this triangle off. And I end up with a perfect octagon. This one's already been cut down. Taking my batting, whatever I'm using for batting, and you can use flannel, you can use an extra piece of batting left over from a project, or in my case I've used fusible Pellon. I will attach my octagon to my batting, and I started out with a half a yard of batting, and I cut that down, so this is actually a fat quarter as well. Making sure that I've left at least 3 inches on the top and 3 inches on the bottom, 3 inches on each side. All right, now I have cut my inner border strips at 1 1/4 inches according to the directions. And the first set of strips I've cut 4 5 3/4 inch rectangles. These are my A strips. And what I'm going to do is lay the A strips on one edge of the octagon, skip an edge, lay the second strip on, skip an edge, lay the third strip on, skip an edge, lay the fourth strip on. I want to make sure that the center of my strip is at the center point of the edge of the octagon. Once I've got those on, I'm going to go to my sewing machine and sew these strips. These are right sides together now. The strip is right side to the right side of the octagon. I'm going to sew these on with a scant 1/4 inch seam. All right, from my other inner border strip of 1 1/4 inch wide, I have cut 4 8-inch long rectangles. On the remaining sides of the octagon, I will place these 4 strips, so they are right sides together, again centering the middle of the strip with the middle of the octagon edge. I should back up and say I have opened up my previous ones and ironed them in place, so everything is open there that I have sewn. Once these 4 are in place, I will take them to my machine, and again I will sew with a scant 1/4 inch seam. These little triangles can be zipped off with your scissors. We won't need them there, or you can leave them, it really doesn't matter. Now I've attached my last inner border strips and I've pressed them open, and I'm ready for the outer border strips. These were cut from 2 1/2 inch strips. This first one is about 6 3/4 inches long. I'm going to place those the original place where I had started the inner border. Skip an edge, do the second strip, skip an edge, third strip, skip an edge, fourth strip. Again, you want to make sure that the center of your is at the center of the octagon edge. After I sew those on with my scant 1/4 inch seam allowance, I'm going to iron those open, and I'm going to go ahead and then take the last set of my 2 1/4 inch strips, which have been cut 12 inches long, and I will attach those to the other 4 sides of my octagon, sewing those on and pressing them all open, at which time I'll be ready to put the backing to my placemat onto the top.
Go.
All right, I have added my outer borders and sewn them on and ironed them back. And now I'm ready to trim my placemat to its octagon shape. The first thing I will do is to choose a side and lining up my ruler with the edge of the first pink, in this case pink outer border strip, at 2 1/4 inches, and I will trim that off. Turn it. Again, lining this up at the 2 1/4 inch mark, I will trim this side. And continue all the way around. Sides to go. Oops, the rotary cutter slipped there. Let's line this up a little better. And now I have my octagon placemat ready for the backing. Take my fat 1/4. That I'm going to use for the backing, and with the right sides together, I will lay my octagon over the backing, and I'm going to sew all the way around at a scant 1/4 inch, maybe even a little bit less than that if I can manage it. But what I will need to do is leave an opening, approximately 6 inches long, 5 to 6 inches long, so that I can turn this right sides out and then finish it up. When it's done and it is turned right sides out, actually after it's done sewing, then I can trim the backing so that it matches the top, turn it inside out or right sides out, and then I'll be ready to do some quilting to hold the three layers together. And you can either echo the octagon, you can start at the center and do a pie, you can just do an all over meander. It's a good place to practice your free motion machine quilting. You can also, if you choose, you can do this, cut your backing down to match your front, and using bias binding, you can bind, just bind your placemat as you normally would a quilt rather than turning it inside out. But again, you would have to use bias binding because of the corners. The octagon placemat will work any size. You can make a larger table topper if you want. You just need to start out with a larger square. You can make a smaller hot pad, just start out with a smaller square. Have fun, experiment with your scraps, and don't forget, it's fat quarter friendly.
Hold it up once so that you can see the picture of it. It's in the light, it's hard to see the color. Okay.
You can get the pattern to make the octagon table topper placemat from KarensQuiltShop.com. As well, we have kits available, which include the instructions.